In this lecture, I'm going to show you how to loop over lists. So here we have a list of three items. We can use our for loops to loop over this list. So for letter in letters, colon, and then we print each letter. Save the changes and run the code. We get A, B, C. Now, what if we want to get the index of each item as well? Well, we have a built-in function called enumerate. We call it here, and this will return an enumerate object, which is iterable. In each iteration, this enumerate object will give us a tuple. Let me show you. So now when we run this code, look, in each iteration, we're getting a tuple. So a tuple, as I told you before, is like a list, but it's read-only. We cannot add new items to it. So in each iteration, we're getting a tuple of two items. The first item in this tuple is the index, and the second item is the item at that index. So now to get the index, we can use square brackets to access the first item in this tuple. So if we print letter of 0, we will get the indexes. And right next to that, we can add letter of 1. So we will see the item at a given index. But this syntax is a little bit ugly. In the last lecture, you learned about list unpacking. So if we have a list with two items, 0 and A, we can unpack it into two variables like this, index, comma, letter equals items. So here we are unpacking the items list. Now, what if we change square brackets to parentheses? Now we have a tuple and we can still unpack this tuple. So you saw that this enumerate function returns an enumerate object, which is iterable. In each iteration, this enumerate object will return a tuple that looks like this. So we can unpack it right here. So we add another variable, index. Now with this, we no longer have to use square brackets and we can simply print index and letter. Let's run this code. There you go. So now we don't need this anymore. So to recap, you can use for loops to iterate over lists. If you also need the index, you should call the enumerate function. This will return an enumerate object, which is iterable. In each iteration, it will return a tuple, and you can unpack that tuple right here. Hi guys, thank you for watching this tutorial. My name is Mosh Hamadani, and I have tons of tutorials like this for you on my channel. So be sure to subscribe, and also please like and share this video. If you want to learn Python properly from scratch with depth, I have a comprehensive Python tutorial for you. The link is below this video, so click the link to get started. Thank you and have a fantastic day.